left subclavian directly arch of aorta se niklega. That is what you need to remember. So if you take the branches of the arch of aorta, you have a right brachiocephalic dividing into right common carotid and right subclavian, then left common carotid, left subclavian, occasionally thyroidea ima artery and vertebral artery. They may arise from the arch of aorta directly. Now, inferior thyroid artery, from where does it arise? It arises from the thyrocervical trunk, which is coming from the first part of the subclavian artery, is what you need to remember. Achcha bhai, ye bhi dekh lenge. So, if you take arch of aorta, left subclavian is coming here, brachiocephalic trunk is coming, from that the right subclavian is coming, from that the thyrocervical trunk is coming, and from that you are getting the inferior thyroid artery. So that is what examiner is asking. Thyrocervical trunk, jiska baap hai right subclavian, the subclavian, jiska baap hai brachiocephalic, jiska baap hai arch of aorta. So this is the important order that you need to remember. Now, what is the level at which common carotid branches into external carotid and internal carotid? Anatomical levels barabar rehna hai doctor. Upper border of the thyroid cartilage is the place where you have the common carotid branching. So common carotid artery, if you take, it branches at the upper border of the thyroid cartilage. Thyroid cartilage, Adam's apple malum hai, uske upper border pe it is basically dividing. What is the arterial supply of trachea? Very important question. From an anesthetist, some of you are going to be anesthetists. Anesthesia perspective also, it is very, very important. MD entrance or MDS entrance, sabke liye yahi common question hai. So you should remember, it is inferior thyroid artery, which is the main supply. Keep punching answers, doctor. Very good. I can be able to see you all punching the answers. So, inferior thyroid artery. So if you look at the trachea, doctor, upper trachea is supplied by inferior thyroid artery and lower part of the trachea is by the branches of the bronchial artery, is what you need to remember. Then venous drainage, inferior thyroid venous plexus. So thyroid trachea, trachea thyroid, they both are very closely related. So isliye special artery kyun bolke bhagwan ne socha, trachea ke liye tracheal artery, superior tracheal artery, thank god there are no such things. Inferior thyroid artery is the main blood supply, upper part of trachea, and the branches of the bronchial artery are the main supply in the lower part, is what you need to remember. Now this is a very interesting illustration, doctor. How closely the esophagus is hugging the trachea. Titanic movie dekha na? Titanic movie mein the hero and heroine stand on the top of the deck, right? Where he'll be embracing the heroine, right? Titanic. Like that, you have a trachea and esophagus. So, typically, this place, the primary tracheal artery, primary esophageal artery, secondary tracheal branch on the posterior wall. So, you have the tracheoesophageal artery. So, trachea and esophagus are very close. That's the reason there can be a fistula which can develop between the two. Tracheoesophageal fistulas can develop very easily, is what you need to do.